Grace and peace to you, my friends. Thank you for joining us in prayer. I'm Father Ron Hoy, and this is the God Minute. We're really glad you're with us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips.
And my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 24, The Glorious King. Everything and everyone belongs to you, Lord. Who then ascends into the presence of the Lord? And who has the privilege of entering into God's holy place?
Those who are clean, whose works in ways are pure, whose hearts are true and sealed by truth, they will receive the Lord's blessing and righteousness given by our Savior God.
They will stand before God, for they seek the pleasure of God's face. So wake up, lift high your heads. Welcome the King of Glory, for he is about to come through. Wake up and rejoice.
You ask, who is the King of Glory? He's the Lord of victory, armed and ready for battle, the Mighty One, the invincible commander of heaven's hosts. Yes, he is the King of Glory.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
A reading from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 11, verses 28 through 30. Jesus said, "Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy and my burden light." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Today's reading is very enticing for those of us who are busy. Many of us are burdened by many preoccupations. To imagine slowing down and resting sounds really nice, but it's also very challenging. Oddly enough, it can feel like one more thing to get done. Nevertheless, we can feel the need for rest. We can acknowledge that perhaps we do not need to be constantly connected to our digital platforms, work unreasonable hours, or for that matter, be acting like busybodies, running around, doing many things and not accomplishing much. So how do we slow down? What could genuine rest look like? Where is our respite? While Jesus does not give us a complete formula for rest, he does provide helpful insights and direction. He says, "Come to me if you are burdened." He invites us to come near him. Then we are to take up his yoke and learn from him. Now, I admit, this hardly seems like a winning formula, especially when we are trading one set of burdens for another. What are we to make of this exchange? What is the learning? Part of the wisdom has to do with shifting our attitude. Jesus is telling us that the fundamental spiritual rest, that which we really need, is not rooted in external exchanges, but in the deeper matters of the heart. As he says, "Learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart." Jesus shows us that the attitudes needed are those of meekness and humility. In other words, letting go of external things will not give us the deeper spiritual respite we need. Our burdens will be heavier if we hold on to toxic attitudes rooted in resentment, envy, narcissism, hate, or violence. Jesus offers us an alternative path. In his words and actions, we see how meekness can become a transformative force for our own lives and for the world. The same can be said of our attitudes and behaviors. Our labors, exchanges, and encounters can yield different results when we operate with humble hearts. Today, as we come to Jesus, we pray that our hearts will be open to receive the rest and the lightness of spirit that he offers us so freely.
As Javier was reflecting, I was thinking of Peggy's reflection on Tuesday with us here. The need to listen to God in our lives. And now today with Javier's reflection, slowing down so that listening can happen. Two things we're not good at, slowing down and listening. And so we turn to God now, asking his help to do just that.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. Father, kindle within our hearts the fervor of your love. Help us see ourselves from your eyes, not ours, and reject the voice of the devil that says, "You're not good enough." We ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
This Saturday is the Feast of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. So be sure to join us on the podcast for Marian Saturday to learn all about Our Lady and the devotion of her brown scapular. It's going to be on our app blog, our website blog, to find out some more information, as well as the scapular blessing itself. So promises to be a beautiful moment to quiet and to listen and to open our hearts to Jesus this Saturday. Our Lady of Mount Carmel. Folks, thanks for joining us today. May yours be blessed, and may God hold you in protection in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We'll see you tomorrow.